Bosch microwave. The issue I'm having is no power. So, and it shuts down after like 2 or 3 seconds. So, I believe the fuse has blown. It's an inline fuse. I took it out, and I believe the reason why it's shutting down is the magnetron is bad. So I unplugged that. So I'm gonna show you guys what to check. So this is the original fuse that blew out, and I got my digital meter here. I put it on so I can check for continuity and to make sure if I put these two leads on the end, I should get a beeping sound. And here's the new fuse I just bought from Home Depot or Lowe's, either one. So if I put these two together, I should get a sound when I touch them. And no movement. So if I put these two together, this is a new one, I should get a sound. See? So that lets me know that this fuse is blown. Like I said, so I wasn't getting any power. And so when I plugged the microwave in, wasn't giving me anything with the old fuse. So I'll show you guys. Old fuse in, plug it up, plugged in, nothing. So give myself a few seconds before I touch that, let that, anything that's juiced up, don't let electrocute me. So I'll pluck this out. Plug it up. As a matter of fact, before I plug it up, let me plug the magnetron back in. Get this back in here. It's hard to do this with one hand. Alright. So I plug it up. Let's just do 1 minute. Cuts off. I'm pretty sure a lot of you are getting the same issue. So get that loose, and you want to move that back some. So you know, sometimes you know that current can still flow and touch those two. So we plug this up, and we'll do a quick minute. So apparently, the magnetron is faulty, so I guess the main board is realizing that it's not getting a signal from the magnetron, and it's telling the microwave to shut off. So, place this buddy right here. You know, pretty sure some of y'all should have the same part number. If not, just match up the part number and replace that, and your microwave is back rolling. Simple as that. You don't need to call out an electrician or anything. Like I say, just make sure you unplug it when you're working on it. And once you finish everything, tighten everything back up, plug it up, test it out, and you should be good to go. All right.